up, y'all? It's the misters.
And we're in the kitchen.
Doing what we do. The combo. You know. We know it's been a minute since we dropped the segment. We took a little step back if you paid attention to the Facebook page. Rebranded everything. New logo, new intro. We wanted to make sure when we came back to you all, we were 100% mystified.
My turn?
I love it.
Mystified.
I love that.
And that's what we are right now. So we about to do the thing. We about to bring you some segments. Many more to come after this one. Truly appreciate the patience. We guarantee you, we will not leave you hanging from this point forward. Baby, you ready to do it?
I'm ready. Are you?
I'm damn sure ready. Let's get it.
All right, y'all. I'm back. Prepping these ribs. Got to get them ready for the grill. Got them on the backside right now. Got to take off what's called the silver skin. It's actually a membrane, a little thin membrane that is on the backside of the ribs that you want to take off. If you leave that on, ribs are going to be tough. So you want to make sure you get that off. It's not the most easiest thing to do, but it's definitely necessary. Then you're gonna go ahead, any excess meat kind of on the backside of it. You want a good St. Louis cut, even. I like taking that extra meat off the backside of it. Actually a nice little treat you can season up and throw right on the smoker too. Just give your ribs a more unified look when they don't have that extra meat on the backside. Still season that up. That's good stuff right there. Just don't want it on the ribs when they cook it. All right, y'all. Everything is ready. These ribs are ready to go. They're ready to be seasoned. Got the silver skin off the backside of both of them. So all of this rub is going to hit the actual meat. It's going to be fantastic. Now, one thing that I like to use is something as a form of a glue to keep the rub on. Now, some people use olive oil or even cooking oil or something along that line. I personally have done that before, but I like using mustard as my paste. It actually gives it a little bit of a tang, and on top of that, it's better at holding on your rub. So it doesn't matter what kind of mustard you want to use. Good old-fashioned mustard. And just put a little nice little thin coat on there and just lather it on. Front, nipple, a little bit on the back side of it. Don't need a whole lot. Enough to get the look, get it coated. Got it nice and ready. Go ahead with whatever choice of rub that you like to use. Now, it's a variation of different types of rubs I like, you know, but I make my own. Sometimes I buy them out the store, but I like some with a little sweet, a little heat. Be generous. A lot of people say, nah, don't put too much on there. Nah. Coat that thing. Get it right. Cover it up. Get them nice and coated up with the rub. Give it good color, good taste. Whole nine. Tap them right, flip them. The back side, same way. Yeah. pap them up a little bit. On to the next slab.
All right, y'all. Got these bad boys ready to go. Charcoal right temperature. Got my top rack ready. Sit them up top here. That's how I like to do mine. I don't like them sitting directly over the fire. You know, low, slow, ready to go. Sit them up top. Give them a little room there. Other rack in, overlap just a little bit. That's all right, they gonna cook real nice and right. Here we go. Be right back to y'all, show you a little bit what it looked like as we move forward. My little nuggets, bro. I like them. Get my little pieces off the backside, man. When I cut those off, they're gonna be the ones I taste. See what it do. Put them back there. In the back. See how I got those lined up? All in the line. One straight line of charcoal. A lot of cats will just have charcoal all over. I like mine in one direct line straight across. So if I need to throw off something to the side and not have it directly over the heat, like I'm doing my nuggets back there, my rib nuggets. They're not directly on the heat. They're gonna catch the heat, but they're not directly on it, so they kind of fall back. Keep that right there. Keep your rib rack up high. Can't go wrong, baby. See you in a few. All right, y'all. Here's those potatoes that I was referring to. Those garlic, rosemary potatoes. Super fire.
All right, good people. About to wrap these ribs. They've cooked long enough to have the bones exposed. That's always important. When you see that meat pull back, you can see the tips of the actual bones. That mean they ready. But I like to wrap mine and put them back on there. I'm using a little bit of sweet heat. I like to give them a little bed, brown sugar. A little bed of brown sugar and butter. Get you some brown sugar, spread it out evenly. Get up with some butter, whatever. You can do sticks, spread, your spray butter, whatever you want to do. Then you lay your rack on there. Right on it. And come back, throw another little bit of brown sugar on top. Spread it out. A little bit more butter on top. Finish it off with a little bit of the rub. A little bit up under there. Wrap, baby. Hold them up. Create a cradle. A lot of times people just want to fold it up I like to bring the tips in. Create a cradle. And you just kind of roll the middle. Cradle the ends. So when those juices build up, they don't spew out the side. Cradle the sides. So it contains all the juices. You just kind of roll slowly. The middle part. And then go back out on the smoker. And give you that finished product. Cut up a couple of them. Show you that thing of beauty.
So I have my bow tie noodles here, and I'm going to prepare. I have some ranch dressing. I'm going to pour it over the Cajun, the noodles, and that's going to give it that Cajun flavor. So it's just some ranch spicy dressing, and I'm just going to mix it. Don't give it a kick that we need. So you want to mix it really well, that all the noodles are coated into the spicy ranch dressing. So that's all mixed well. So we're going to start layering our salad. The first thing we need is our spring mix. So I have this beautiful bowl. I'm just going to top it. This is the bottom of it. So we're going to layer each topping. And we're going to put the salad, the spring mix first. Then we have some Southwestern corn. We're going to put that here. And then we have some rotisserie chicken breast that I pretty much shredded. So we're just going to sprinkle that over it. And then we have some plum tomatoes, which I sliced. That around, and then let's do our noodles, our Cajun spicy noodles. So we're just gonna mix it inside with the spring mix and the corn and the plum tomatoes. Okay, now we're gonna build another layer. So we're gonna start with the salad first. Sprinkle it around. Make sure it's mixed well. And then we're gonna top it again with the tomatoes. We can do it different. You don't have to have the same layers, but you can have it like the tomatoes, the corn. So the corn is the Southwestern kind. And some more rotisserie shredded chicken. Well, and then so that layer is built, and we're gonna top it with some more of the spicy Cajun noodles. Okay, now let's start the last layer, which is the spring mix. Let's do the corn. the last layer, so I'm gonna put all the corn on there. Okay. And let's do the tomatoes. So we're gonna use all the tomatoes because it's our last layer. And let's top it off with our beautiful spicy ranch Cajun noodles. And then let's put some chicken on top. And my favorite, my beautiful cheese. This is the triple cheddar cheese. So we're gonna just sprinkle it around. So we have two different types of tortilla strips. So we have the tricolor. So we're just gonna sprinkle it around the beautiful colors. Okay, and I have another one. It's the Southwestern tortilla strips. It actually is San Jose. Okay, so this guy is the old-time Cajun chicken salad.
All right, good people, it's a done deal.
We're done.
Session is finito. Ribs on point. Potatoes. On point. Salad. On point. Perfect meal for you and your family. We appreciate all the love. Wifey, what you got to say to the people?
I want to thank you guys for giving us so much support via text, inboxes, and just the phone calls. Saying that we inspire you guys to get in the kitchen cooking for your mate,
no
your
doubt.
Family.
No doubt.
We do this out of love. We're the ministers.
We in the kitchen. Catch you on the next video.